Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. We're gonna get started here real shortly. Just getting my music set up for the day. I will run through the what the workout is here in about 30 seconds. Don't wreck my phone. Get this music turned up. All right, let's get some warm-up music ready first. There we go. All right, I think we're rock and rolling. Is that time? Yep, it's that time. All right, so today is Threshold Thursday, and I will tell you, I'm gonna post a picture later. I have a dragonfly that's just sitting right here. It was here when I got here this morning, and it's not dead. I thought maybe it was dead, and that was my delay. I was taking some pictures, so those of you who know me at all know my deal with dragonflies and what that means to me. But anyway, so we're gonna get going. Threshold Thursday, we got a Tabata, Imam, AMRAP, a couple more Imams, another AMRAP, and another Tabata. So, if you don't know what any of those means, doesn't matter. I will be talking you through every single thing that we're doing. I feel like my camera is crooked, but that's okay. I'll get to that in a little bit. So, we're just going to get started with the warm-up. My name is Barbara. Do what you can at your level. I will give alternate ideas for each one in case you have any limitations or injuries or anything like that. We're gonna get started. Here we go. Start with our warm-up, basic warm-up today. Arms at shoulder height, heels kicking back up to your toward your rear end, and pull down, knees up, pull down. Turn your torso toward your knee each time. Get it all warmed up. Get things moving. One more time. Pull back. Arms at shoulder height. Get that chest working. Upper back. Hamstrings and quads. Kicking that rear end. One more time. Pull down. Good. And place your feet down. We're going to take it wide. Bend those knees side to side. Good. Start reaching. Keep that butt low. If you're reaching for your knees, that's fine. Just make sure your butt always stays lower than your head. Good. Hold it on the left. Turn into it. Hips go up and down slowly. Take that left hand up to the sky, look at it, and bring it down, press that elbow down, back up, and bring it down, elbow press down, good, back to the center, hands on the thighs this time, and side to side, keep that butt low, start pressing that shoulder across, get a good twist, get that back warmed up, core, and hold it on the right. Turn into it, up and down slowly. Take that right hand up to the sky. And down. Up to the sky. And down. Good, bring those feet closer together. Hips go up and down. Whatever is comfortable for you. Hips up, roll it up slowly. Roll out those shoulders, start that jog. Light jog, checking out your area. Make sure you got nothing around that's gonna trip you up. All right, bring those knees higher. Keep it going. Good. jab. On your toes. Add that jab cross. Jab cross. Jab cross. Swivel your feet around. Other side. Lead. Jab. 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 Add in that jab cross. Again, you don't have to jump. Stop. Get those arms moving. Take it into an ice skater. Catch the mirror in between if you can. Otherwise, no jumping. Keep it low. Good. Take it back to a light jog. Are we ready? We are going to start off with a Tabata. This dragonfly is just something else. It's just sitting there. Its wings go up, coming back down. It's very interesting. Anyway, Tabata is going to be all core. We're starting off. It's going to be a V-sit. Well, V in and out, basically. Right here. In, out. In, out. That's going to be the first one. You're going to take it over. We're doing plank jacks. You can do them on your elbows or on your hands. If you don't want to do either, you can stand up and do jacks. Then we're going to take it into a plank right here. Sorry, 2 feet. And then we're going to flip it over and take it into flutter right here. Okay, so 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. Let's get this music started. Are we ready? We have Tabata on the clock. Gonna count us down 10 seconds. Get yourself ready. We are starting with that V in and out. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Out and in. Chin is off your chest. Look up where the wall meets the ceiling. 12 reps, and then you're going to come right into this and do a work your quad right here, extending that leg, 8, 10, or 12. You got to get both of those in within 1 minute. If you want to add resistance, you're going to go ahead and put this around your foot on both sides for the ham curl. Actually, I'm going to do it like this for the ham curl. You're going to be pulling one foot up. Actually, how do I want to do this? So I can go right in the other one. Yeah, 1 foot up right here. So around the ankle of the foot that's moving, under the foot of the one that's stationary. So then as soon as you finish those, you're going to come right here and you're going to do your leg extensions. Same leg. Next time through, we'll do the other leg. Okay? I'm not going to use the bands because they tend to mess up my already weak knee when I do the ham curls. So we're gonna move on. We got emails. We're doing this 4 times. All right, it's gonna count us down. We got 10 seconds, ham curls. You can also use the long band for a ham curl. This one I can do. 2, 1, go, go. You're counting for yourself. 8, 10, or 12 of each before you're done for this round. Starting in 15 seconds, switch legs. Every minute on the minute, EMOM, every minute on the minute. 9 seconds, we're starting that other side. 4, 3, 2, 1, other leg. You count for yourself. Think about those muscles back there that you're flexing. Flex, bring that foot up toward the butt. You're flexing these hamstring muscles, glutes. Right into your front leg extension. Working the top of that leg, quad. You can feel it. Put your hand there, you'll feel it. 30 seconds left. Keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. As I fall over, keep going. 20 seconds until we start round 3. Morning, Lisa. 15 seconds. We're going back to the other side. Keep it going. go right in together. Core is tight. Hopefully you don't have to hold on to anything. You can really challenge yourself. If you're finding it too challenging, grab a wall, grab a chair, whatever you need to do. You can also take your leg down further. It can be a lower extension. Just think about that front muscle, top muscle, those quadriceps on that leg. You got 15 seconds until we do that final leg. Starting that final one. Enough gets me down. Two, one, here we go. Good. Core is tight. Anytime we're exercising, we gotta keep our core tight. Even when you're not exercising, you need to start thinking about keeping it tight. If you don't already, think about it. Not just hanging around with a jelly belly. No matter how thin you are, you don't just let your belly hang out. Keep going. Woo! I'm not counting for myself, so you guys just keep going. We got 20 seconds left in this one, and we're moving on. 15 seconds. Grab yourself a drink if you're done already. 9 seconds. All right. 3, 2, 1. Good. All right, we're going into our first AMRAP. AMRAP means as many rounds as possible. You're going to be doing this on your own. It's only 3 minutes long. It is all cardio. You're going to be doing a slam ball. Okay, so if you actually have a slam ball, feel free to use it. You can also use a pillow. Pillows work really well with this. So right here, slam ball, bringing it all the way up and slamming down. My knees are bent, okay? Down. That's our slam ball, 10 reps. Then you're gonna go into ice skaters. Ice skaters are, we did those in the warm-up, right here. You can add a hop to it. 2, 2, 3, 3. 10 on each side. Then you're gonna go into skiers, 10 of them. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, that's skiers. You can also step, just make sure those arms are going. And then you're gonna do jab cross, 10 on one side, jab cross, 10 on the other side. Everything is 10, okay? I will be doing it to remind you what's coming up next. I did not put it in the notes. Slam ball, ice skaters, skiers, jab cross. Are we ready? You've got 3 minutes on the clock. It's gonna be fast, you gotta go fast. All right, here we go. What are we doing? Here we go. Music, that's what I'm forgetting. Are we ready? Slam ball, ice skaters. 3, 2, 1, go. 3 minutes, that's all we got. 10 reps of each. You're gonna do a slam ball. If you don't have a slam ball, you're right here. Pulling down, pull. And you're pulling, and you're pulling all the way down. Let those legs bend. Use that core, contract. You get 10 of those done, you're going right into ice skaters. Now, if you don't want to jump, you're keeping it low, you're keeping that core tight, that's your ice skaters. You want to bring that hop into it, catch the mirror in between, so make sure you got space. If you finish your ice skaters, 10 on each leg, you're going to do 10 skiers. Swishing down those slopes, right here. If you want to step, you can. Just pull the arms. Get that heart rate up. Then you got 10 jab cross on each side. We are 1 minute in already. Go, go, go. When you're doing that jab cross, you're on your toes, moving, your core is tight, you're punching all the way out. We're not just doing this. Okay, it's punch, 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 punch. Bend to the other side, 10. You finish all those, you go right back into slam ball. We got a minute and a half left. Let's get through it. You're moving on for yourself. You're doing your pace. Don't have to follow me. today, 7 rounds. I forgot to say that at the beginning. And we already finished 3. So we're going into round 4. We have an EMOM, every minute on the minute. It's going to be, you can use this with a band or with a, or with weights. I'll show you with a band. It is going to be a reverse fly. Right here, you can use 1 foot or 2 feet, depending on the level of resistance that you want. So you're going to be doing a reverse fly. Feet are together. You're bending over, you're hinging right here, and you're gonna bring those arms up straight. Well, like slight bend in the elbows, okay? But we're not doing a pullback. We're doing arms out like a fly, okay? And then we're gonna move into above. We're gonna bring them straight up to the front. All right, that's if you're using a band. Same thing with a weight, but you just have a weight in each hand. And we're gonna be doing, how many did I write down? 8, 10, or 12 again. You have to fit both of them into a minute. 8 reps, 10 reps, or 12 reps, okay? So, let's get ready. I will be doing this with you. We're doing this 3 times through. Here we go. Position so the toes are pointed out, and you're going to be doing a sumo up and down. This is what the legs are going to look like. All right, your arm is going to look like this. It's going to come down halfway and back up right here. All right, so everything is up and then everything is down. Up and down. One side only. Second time through, legs stay the same. Other side arm though. Okay, here we go. We got four EMOMs. You're choosing 12, 16, or 20 reps. 12, 16, or 20. Here we go. Let's get sexy back. And
you ready?
Are we ready? All right, let's reset my clock. Here we go. Three, two, one, start it up. Good. You're counting for your, counting for yourself? 12, 16, or 20. 12, 16, or 20. Don't follow me. Don't wait for me. I'm just talking to you, helping you with what you need to do. Slam ball, ice skaters, skiers, and jab cross, okay? I'll be doing them as well, 10 reps of each. You only have 3 minutes. Are we ready to rock and roll? Let's get 3 minutes on the clock. Okay, we are ready. Music's up. Slam ball, where we're starting. 3, 2, 1, go. You got 3 minutes. Let's see if you can get more done than you did last time. So you have an option. So if you do not like being on the ground on your hands, your option is going to be, let me get some weights actually, right here. Your alternative is right here, and you're going to do a pull back. Okay? So right here looks like this, pulling back one and the other. Now, if you would rather do just one and concentrate on just one arm, that's fine. You're squeezing that shoulder blade every single time. Same thing on the ground. You're gonna be doing the same exact movement, and we are doing it for 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. The second exercise, if you are on the ground, well actually let me show you what's standing up. So if you're standing up, it's gonna be right here. Your arms are up like an X, bringing opposite toe up to hand. So this is your alternative, standing up and doing this. Otherwise, you will have just done your pullbacks right here, which you can do on your knee or on your toes, up. You can focus on one arm only. And then you're gonna flip it over and you're gonna do an X crunch, star crunch, whatever you wanna call it. And you're gonna be right here You can focus on one leg only if you want, or you can alternate each time. Okay? So that's what you're doing. It's only a half Tabata, so this is only 2 minutes, 20 seconds of each. All right, so we're gonna do each one twice. That's it, and we're done. We ready to rock and roll? Here we go. Tabata. It's counting us down. 10 seconds on the clock. Get ready. If you wanna do this on the ground, do your pullbacks control. Three, two, one. Squeezing that shoulder blade to the back every time I bring it up. My feet are wide, and I'm keeping that butt down. It's not here. Keep that butt down. Squeeze. Two, one, rest. Turn it over. Get ready for that star crunch. In five, four, three, two, one. Here we go. I'm doing one side only this time. Second time, I'm going to do the other side. For that Tabata. All right, so lay it out long. This was 23 minutes of work. Reach. Good. Now bring that right knee in toward your chest. Give it a good squeeze in. Massage that hip flexor. If you need to pull under the knee, that's fine. If you want to use a towel around your knee, that's fine. Anything pulling it in. Now pull it out to the armpit area, up to the corner, pulling it. You're not just holding it, you're pulling it. Get a good stretch in that inner thigh. And relax that, bring it back to sitting on the ground. Arms out to the side like a T. You're gonna take that bent knee, drape it over that straight right leg. You're gonna give a little shift to your hips, so your hips kinda come up, and then you're gonna bring that leg over. You can put your leg out straight, you can have it bent, however you want. The key is make sure that arm is staying on the ground, the shoulder is on the ground, the palm is down. You can take that opposite hand and lay it on that knee if you need a little bit more of a stretch. And then the second key is to make sure that that bottom leg just melts right into the mat. Relax that glute, that bottom leg, let it melt into the mat. Keep breathing. And release that, let that knee come back up. That leg that's straight, you're gonna bring that ankle onto that bent knee. You're gonna bring it all in toward your chest, reach through, and give a nice gentle pull. If you're not able to reach through or you don't like that, you can always just pull right here on the outsides, okay? You could even just bring this leg closer because you can always move this leg up. You can hold it here, whatever is working for you, okay? So you feel that stretch in that hip and glute area. Good, and release that. That bent leg goes down straight, other knee comes in. Give it a good squeeze up toward your chest. breathe in. Take it out toward your armpit. Pulling, not just holding, pulling so you get an inner thigh stretch. And release it. Foot's back on the ground, arms are out to the side like a T. Shift those hips just a little bit and then let that bent leg come over that straight leg. Making sure that that hand and shoulder stay on the ground. If you need more of a stretch, replace that hand on that knee. Make sure you're letting that bottom leg just melt right into the mat. That glute is relaxing into the mat or floor or whatever you're on. Good, release that. Take that straight leg, ankle up onto the knee. Bring it all in toward your chest. And give a little extra oomph, a little pull. Compress into this outer knee to get even deeper stretch into that hip and glute. Make sure you're breathing. Good, release that. One hand behind each knee, rock yourself up. Rolling it over on our hands and knees. Right here. All right, hands are under shoulders. Knees are a little bit further than hip width apart. We're gonna do child's pose, which means you let your rear end go over your heels, as close to them as you can, then you stretch your arms out. Head goes between the arms, keep those arms stretched out. Feel that stretch along the lats of your back. Good. Walk your hands over to the right. Feel a stretch down that left side of your body, all the way from your triceps, through your armpit, down the lats, into the waist, and walk your hands over to the other side. Keep those the rear end over the heels if you can. And hands back to the front, stretch them out. Good, head up on your hands and knees, tuck those toes under, pop that rear end up in the air. Whatever's comfortable, you can keep your knees bent if you need to. Let yourself just hang. Eyes are open. Eyes are open. And right now I want you to tighten your belly. Come up slowly. Eyes are open. Keep breathing. Tighten your belly. Coming up slowly. Eyes are open. Keep breathing. All right. And we are going to take our left hand out to the side. And you're going to bring it all the way across. And then your other arm comes up and under. And just a gentle pull. The key here is keep that shoulder away from your ear. You're not doing this. You're not getting a stretch. Push that shoulder down. You want a stretch across the top and back of that shoulder. So keep that shoulder away from the ear. And release it. Other arm comes out. Bring it across. This opposite arm comes up and under. And pull across. Push that shoulder away from the ear. Shoulder away from the ear. And release that. Stagger stance. Big deep breath in. Arms come up. And exhale. Relax those shoulders. Breathe. One more big inhale. Arms come down. Shoulders relax. Good. And that is our Threshold Thursday. I'm not as sweaty as normal. Not sure what's going on. Anyway, it's all good. That's it. I'm glad that you guys came. Thanks so much for my livers. I always appreciate that. I do want to give a little, viewing of this dragonfly that has not moved. And I know it's not dead because the wings keep moving. So. He's a little baby guy. He's been there all morning. He barely moved. So. Anywho. That's the end of my workout. This is Barbara. Thank you guys so much for coming. And I hope to see you on Saturday morning, 8:15 Eastern. Have a great rest of your day. Stay safe, keep your distance, and send love out to everybody. Bye.